So good afternoon everyone. So if you remember in the last lecture, we have seen total three MAC layer access processes. Okay, we have started with first, that is MAC layer, that is DFW MAC DCF using CSMA CA. Okay, after that we have seen two more technique. Okay, next one we have seen DFW MAC DCF with RTS CTS extension, both are DCF. Then lastly we have seen DFW MAC ECF with polling, which is rarely used. After that we have started with the WLAN new standard, because 802.11 standard was developed, and after that certain new standards are developed according to the requirement. So 802.11b is the standard that we have seen in the last lecture. So there is one more standard, that is 802.11a standard. Okay, so we'll see that now. Okay, so as the time went on, immediately users and vendors, they have tried to achieve a better data rate for faster communication than what we have seen in the 802.11b. okay, so further in around 2001, okay, new standard was standardized by the IEEE, and that was called as a 802.11a. okay, so it was made available in 2001. okay, the difference in standard 802.11b and standard 802.11a is that the data range and a transmission range. Okay, so most of the other things that you will see are common. Frequency is also somewhat different. Okay, so I can say three factors are different. Ek hai data rate, then hai transmission range, and frequency band. Okay, so this is to improve the flaws that we have found out in 802.11b and to increase the data rate. Okay, so if you see security, so this is similar to 802.11b. okay, so availability, that is slightly changed. Okay, quality of service is also similar to 802.11b only. Manageability is also similar to 802.11b only. Okay, so so changes in the remaining factors that we will see. So what are the data rates it supports? From 6 Mbps se leke 54 Mbps tak data rate it is supporting. So that is much higher. Okay, B mein dekhoge to it was supporting up to maximum 11 Mbps, but if you see the user data rate, approximately average nikaloge to 6 Mbps tak milta tha, but here you can see the data rate is increased now, and we can achieve maximum data rate up to 54 Mbps. That is much higher. So maximum data rate achieved in the user is 802. Mein kitna tha? 6 Mbps. Now 802.11a starts with 6 Mbps. Okay, so we can imagine how much higher rate is achieved. Okay, so up to 54 Mbps data rate was supported. Okay, the throughput is now modified to a very good level, so like 5.346 Mbps tak throughput it was giving. That means if 6 Mbps data rate is supported, user data rate will be 5.3. this is for 6 Mbps. agar 6 Mbps ka hai to maximum approximately data rate aapko 5.3 tak mil raha hai. Okay, so if you take the ratio, so that will be up to 5.36 Mbps ka 5.3 is something around 85% to 90% tak mil raha hai. 85% pakad de, 85% tak we are getting. ओके द थ्रूपुट ओके सो दैट इज वेरी गुड इम्प्रोवाइजेशन थ्रूपुट देखा जाए तो सो फॉर 24 Mbps 84 Mbps यूजर डेटा इज सपोर्टेड ओके फॉर 36 कितना सपोर्ट हो रहा है 24 Mbps एंड फॉर 54 राउंड अबाउट 32 Mbps डेटा रेट इज सपोर्टेड ओके सो एज यू मूव टू द हायर फ्रीक्वेंसी द थ्रूपुट इज क्वाइट गेटिंग डिक्रीज ओके सो दैट इज वन ऑफ द लिमिटेशन इन द ट्रांसमिशन रेंज एंड दैट रेंज वॉज चेंज फ्रॉम 300 मीटर आउटडोर टू 100 meter outdoor because primarily wireless LANs are used in a closed space so there is no point in providing higher range in the outdoor so 100 meter outdoor was standardized and 10 meter indoor was standardized okay so most of the home users were comfortable with 802.11a okay so this data rate supported okay and it is data rates are supported based on their distance so that is up to 5 meter data rate achieve is the maximum but as you move away from the access point definitely that is if you move away from the access point up to suppose 60 meter then only 12 Mbps can be achieved okay so these are the different data rates maximum you can get up to 5 meter but again that is practically not possible practically 2-3 meter range mein 4 meter range mein you will get maximum then once you move away from the access point it will start decreasing the data rate will start decreasing maximum 12 Mbps tak ka mil sakta up to 60 meter but that is not actually possible 60 meter mein milta bhi nahi hai bahut bar okay so now one of the flaws of 802.11b was ISM band we are still using ISM band but ISM band has another frequency range also that is in the 5 gigahertz agar aapko ya pata hai to now two bands our access points are supporting routers agar aap ghar pe laate ho if you are using wireless LAN at your home wireless net at your home so routers are supporting now two different bands 2.4 gigahertz ka band bhi aapko milta hai along with that 5 gigahertz ka band bhi they are providing nowadays so free ISM band in the 5 gigahertz is utilized here and 5.15 to around 5.25 okay 5.25 to 5.35, 5.725 to 5.825 gigahertz ka ISM band they are providing. Okay, so now you can use that. Okay, so there are three frequency bands. Alag alag ek hai, this one, this is the first one. Okay, this is the second one that we are getting and this is the third one that we are getting. Okay, that is the ISM band. Okay, so these are used by the 802.11a. So, abhi aapke ghar pe jo routers available hai, that are supported by 802.11a, not by B. Okay, that you remember. Okay, if you are using any product that is only supporting 2.4 gigahertz ISM band, then it supposed to have a 802.11a B standard. Okay, if it is supporting both, then definitely your product is supporting 802.11a standard. That you remember. Okay, so physical layer also uses DSSS, that is spread spectrum, but at much higher data rate. So this is also using a DSSS based physical layer, but at much higher data rate. Security availability is now same through it uses WEP and since we are using a 5 gigahertz ISM band, only some products or some vendors used to support that, but dheere dheere all the products will be start supporting that. Okay, so there are less availability in the market, so connection time is similar to B version, connection less and always on. That characteristic is with wireless, every wireless product we are getting nowadays. Okay, so if we talk about the advantages and disadvantages, so now advantage is that it fits into 802.x standard. Okay, that is 11a, 11b, 11, like that. WiMAX, which is again 802.16 standard WiMAX wireless broadband. It is also fitting well with the particular wireless LAN. Again, free ISM band, that is the advantage. Availability, it is available, okay, with many of the products. Then since some products and some vendors, but nowadays I think everyone is using 5 gigahertz GSM, sorry, 5 gigahertz ISM band for products they are using. Okay, then lesser amount of interference will be there. Again, simplicity, simple, it is simple, uses less crowded 5 gigahertz band. Less crowded, why? Because 5 gigahertz bands pe abhi tak sare ke sare devices are not supporting, so because less number of application available in 5 gigahertz band, so isliye simple hai and less crowded hai. Lesser amount of interference wo bhi hai. Then if we talk about the drawbacks, so drawback is it's stronger fading due to the higher frequency we are using. So even though interference was less, its impact was larger because of the higher frequency. Okay, so then the quality of service, then issue, if fading is there, otherwise stronger shading nahi, it is stronger fading actually. Is stronger fading, means interference agar nahi hai, but because of 5 gigahertz bands it might be possible ki fading ho sakta hai. Okay, so that,
sir,
yes,
in the user throughput, like we have 32 54 and 24 in bracket, that what does the thing in the bracket indicate, like what do they stand
here for? You are talking about throughput.
Yes,
throughput is what, see, suppose you are having a particular product, okay, that is supporting a 6 Mbps data rate. That means if you are trying to download, it must support a 6 Mbps data rate. Okay, because that data rate is supported by that particular product. But actually throughput is what you are actually getting while downloading. So downloading ke time pe you might have seen, even if you are using a particular router at your home and wireless LAN at your home, so though it is providing you, suppose if you are taking a 25 Mbps line, but still it will not provide you the whole 25 Mbps speed. It will definitely going to provide somewhat lesser speed. Okay, so that is actually throughput. Throughput is what you are getting actually. Okay, so what it is telling, if you are using a 6 Mbps wala data rate, then it is actually providing you up to 5.3 Mbps.
Okay, 5.3.
And if you are using 24 Mbps wala data rate wala standard, then it is providing you 18 Mbps. That is actual speed or actual data rate you are getting. And if you are trying to get 54 Mbps data rate wala product, then it will support you up to 32 Mbps. It is not supporting you actually 54 Mbps, but throughput it will provide you up to 32 Mbps because of many reasons. Because of, you might have seen, though we are using the wireless LANs, So frequencies are there. So somewhat interference will be there in the air. So it will not support the actual data rate. So it will support up to certain level. So as you goes on increasing the data rate, you might have seen 5.3. If you check out for 6 Mbps, 5.3 is almost 85%. But if you goes on increasing, suppose if you are taking 54 Mbps to 54 ka 32 is it is almost 64% it is providing. That means it is quite less. Okay, so that's what it is. Throughput is mean. What that is a mean of throughput. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that's what. So disadvantage is mitna nahi, but only the feeding will be the disadvantage and quality of service will be the issue if feeding hota hai to. Okay, so that is not that is depend on how feeding will be there. Okay, so that is the only limitation what we have in 802.11a. but nowadays whatever standards we are using are based on 802.11a only. If you are using mobiles, recent mobiles, okay, जो अभी अभी market में गए एक साल में आए हैं, या फिर routers which are launched recently in 1 or 2 years, so you will see that it will providing you two bands. एक है 2.4 gigahertz का band that normally we had before that also, जो 802.11b को भी support करता है, but now they are providing one more ISM band, okay. That is 5 gigahertz band and it is having three different frequencies. One is ranges between 5.15. So product which are available in the market, they should provide these frequencies. If you are belonging to this frequency, ek hai 5.15 to 5.25 gigahertz band, dusra hai 5.25 to 5.35 gigahertz band and tisra hai 5.75 to 5.825 gigahertz band. If your product is supporting these three bands, then definitely you can able to get this particular ISM band, frequency band. Definitely if you are using this, then you could able to achieve the maximum data rate possible in the 802.11a standard. Okay, so that's what they are. Again, the distance will vary. If you are using 2.4 gigahertz wala band, the distance that you are getting for transmission range will be different, and if you are using 5 gigahertz wala band, definitely higher frequency will provide you the better distance. So that's what the meaning of it. Okay, so that is what the IEEE 802.11a and 11b standards are.